Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can use simple if and if else statements in PHP. Before starting, you can note my information. You can subscribe my YouTube channel if you want to learn programming. You can connect with me by following these information. You can also download my Android app, that is TechImage, which is available on Google Play. So now coming on to the topic. First of all, before start writing PHP script, you have to start Apache web server, which is provided by XAMPP control panel. So I have opened XAMPP control panel. Now I am going to start Apache web server. So PHP is a server-side scripting language. That's why we need to start Apache web server every time whenever we want to run PHP script. So I am minimizing XAMPP control panel. Now I am opening the Notepad++ software. So here you can see basic instructions are already available, which are in HTML and PHP. So I have empty PHP tag available in this code. So I'm going to write some instructions to demonstrate how you can use if or if else statements in PHP. So before starting, first of all, I am going to save this code. Then I will be writing instructions. So for saving, I have to click on file, then save it. I am saving this code in D drive. D drive contains a XAMPP folder. Inside XAMPP, htdocs. Inside htdocs, I have created my own folder, testweb. So you have to follow this path. If your XAMPP folder is available in any other drive, then you have to open or you have to follow that drive path. So I have opened testweb folder. Now I am saving this file with if.php. So whenever your HTML code contains PHP tag, then you have to save that file with .php extension. So now I am going to demonstrate you how you can use simple if. So for that purpose, I am going to use a variable age, and I am assigning 30 into it. So age of a person is 30, let's say. Now I want to check whether this person is eligible for vote or not. So I am considering the criteria of voting 18 or above. So I am applying if $age greater than equals to 18. So this is a simple if condition. If age is greater than equals to 18, then this condition will be true, otherwise it will be false. So to display any message, I am using echo statement. So I have written eligible for vote in echo statement. So now I am saving this code and I am moving to web browser. And I'm typing localhost slash testweb slash if.php and I'm pressing enter. So you can see the output is displayed as eligible for vote because this condition is true. Now suppose age is 15 and condition is age greater than equals to 18. So let's see what happens when we refresh the browser. So you can see no output is displayed now because if condition is false and I have not provided any alternative statement whenever this condition will be false. So if you want to provide an alternate if condition is false, then that alternate will be displayed. So for that purpose, you can use if else statement. So right now I have demonstrated only simple if, which is responsible for true part. If condition is true, then certain set of instruction will be executed. If condition is false, nothing will be performed. So if you want to perform some operation, while your condition is false, then you have to use else statement. So now I am writing else echo not eligible for vote. So now this is if else statement. So if condition is true, then true part will be executed. If condition is false, then else part will be executed. So now I am saving this code. Moving to web browser, I am going to refresh this code. So you can see that right now not eligible for vote is displayed on web browser, because if condition is false, and if this condition is true, then eligible for vote will display on web browser. So friends, this is simple demonstration of if and if else statement. So if you want to focus only on true part, then you can simply use if, then else is optional. And if you want to focus on both true as well as false part, then you have to use if else together. So remember, else is optional. If you are using if, then you can avoid else. But if you are using else statement, then you have to forcefully use if statement, because you cannot implement else without if. So you can implement this demonstration in your systems also, so that you can understand how we can use if or if else statement in PHP. So if you want to learn more programming related videos, you can subscribe my YouTube channel. You can connect with me by following these details. Thank you for watching this video.